Welcome to the Sport Accord World Mind Games 2014, unquestionably one of the highlights of the Mind Games calendar. For those unfamiliar with this unique event, the competition consists of five sports: chess, draughts, bridge, go and Chang'Chi. Once again, over 150 competitors from 37 countries have converged at the Beijing Convention Centre to battle it out for a prize purse of $1.4 million. Once again, Beijing acts as host city for this unique event. For 4 years now, the Chinese capital has provided the backdrop and facilities to make the whole thing tick. With its blend of tradition and state-of-the-art architecture, Beijing, home to some 21 million plus inhabitants, has proved to be an ideal home with its increasing role on the world stage in cultural and sporting events. The throbbing 24-hour metropolis has played host to top-level events from every imaginable sport, from tennis to football and, of course, the unforgettable 2008 Olympic Games. The Chinese government also recognises the value of mind games on show this month, which has formed a close relationship with Sport Accord since 2011. Sport Accord Director General Vlad Baronescu, addressing the media at the traditional press conference, is delighted with the enduring success of the event and especially the key role played by the host city.
We've always had a great support from the Beijing municipal government as well as from Beijing Sports Bureau. I think that the Chinese government understands the importance of sport and how sport can influence the future generations and inspire the athletes and the people to take part in sport. And it's not just as important to practice physical sport as it is to practice mental sport together. So this completes the full circle of the Chinese philosophy in a way to educate the youth with a fun activity such as sport.
For the Beijing Sports Bureau, meanwhile, it continues to be a mutually beneficial relationship.
Beijing started to host the World Mind Games in 2011, and this is now the fourth year. World Mind Games is a comprehensive event that encompasses multiple sports. As the cultural center of China, Beijing is home to a vast number of people who enjoy all kinds of mind games. They have a strong desire for watching and learning from the world's top players. Hosting the World Mind Games is important for these people, and at the same time, it provides an opportunity for the Beijing Sports Bureau to gain more experience in hosting top events like this.
As ever, the Sport Accord World Mind Games has incorporated new and improved features into the event, keeping it fresh and taking advantage of all the media platforms available.
We had the online tournament where we created our own platform, which has been used where registered members can watch the results and can follow the highlights and can follow the video content coming out of the event. This has been the first time done. At the same time as a cooperation with Euronews, where we will push content out and make this event more known around the world, at the same time benefiting from the exposure that each gives to the other.
Marinescu also took the opportunity to acknowledge the vital role played by the raft of sponsors to make the World Mind Games such a successful annual event.
It has progressed throughout the course of the last 4 years. We have reached now the fourth edition, and with each edition we are raising the profile of the event, we are becoming more known around the world, and we are producing a higher quality product for the media. Having an event that now will be distributed to over 40 countries in terms of live and highlights and to over 150 countries in terms of news means that there is an attraction to the public eye for this type of event.
Also on hand at the press conference were the individual ambassadors, another vital ingredient for this unique event. Each discipline has a global ambassador who's responsible for promoting their sport on a national and international level.
It's my honor to be as a chess ambassador because I thought it will be good to promote chess overall, not as a chess player. There's another role for it's a good thing for me because besides playing chess, I can do something more for promote chess in China or even all over the world.
This year's event was officially opened at a lavish opening ceremony with representatives from the local authorities, Sport Accord, the match officials and ambassadors, and of course the players themselves. And with the formalities out of the way, the Sport Accord World Mind Games 2014 was officially open for business. As the Director General so aptly summed it up, let the best minds win. Time now for some action, starting appropriately as we're in China on the Shang-Chi table.
So Black was playing a quite active move by going with a cannon forward five ranks, and now the answer was going out with a horse, so that there's possibly a change with the cannons, or the other possibility to go for red ahead with the right side cannon for ranks. At the moment, it's Black's move. Might be the rook can take now either the pawn at the ninth or in the central line, and might be the central line is more interesting, and really it does now. But no, after going moving out with the cannon out of the center line, there's a little bit of relief for Black, and so might be the bend for a draw is a little bit closer than before. So red changes the rooks, and I think he wants to rely on his power in the end game and try to use the pawns over the river to decide the end game. But at the moment, by moving the pawn ahead in the center, also Black has more choices to come out with his horse. Over the, for example, horse 7 forward 6, because there's not a direct problem with this red horse. Also, the red pawn in the ninth file is under danger if cannon 4. Horizontally goes to 1 from Black, he can attack the cannon. Now the horse is blocking all the escape fields for the king. And the Zhang with the advisor is quite strong. And now comes the killing move, might be. No? The king has to move away. Still some defense. But that seems to be now the real final moves. So the king can only go up or down. So after hard fighting, the German had to give up. But I think it was also very fine played endgame later from the Singapore player, still with some chances for defense.
And it would be Meng Hao Lu from Singapore who took the win to start off his campaign this year on the right footing. Meanwhile, the only sport here not played on a board is bridge. Day one saw a series of closely fought team matches and will start with Monaco against China.
So, in fact, Declara was allowed to make an over trick. No. And that was worth six imps, almost certainly other room. China would have tried four spades and gone down. So here, east, one diamond, and south, modest, one spade overcall. North has a very good hand in support of spades. So you would expect north-south to easily find a route to four spades. To begin with, North bids two diamonds. He simply says to his partner, I have a good hand with support for spades. Well, South can't do anything more exciting than repeat his suit. And now we expect North to jump to four spades. Well, that's, I think, very strange. I think North intended three no trumps to have some conventional meaning and not interpreted as such by South. And so North-South play the doomed three no trumps. They'll lose the first six tricks. Very, very surprising. So Declare has played neatly by taking a club finesse and roughing a spade. He shortened his trumps down to the same length as North's. And now two more rounds of clubs. He can lead a diamond and collect North's trumps. very pretty.
All in all, it was a tense but exciting opening day on the bridge tables. Next up, Go.
If you visit any city here in China, the chances are you will come across a big group huddled around two people playing Go. Often considered to be a game for older players, perhaps a flagship store in the hippest part of Beijing is not where you would expect to be focusing on the game. Burrado's involvement shows just how things are changing in the world of Go as a new generation of players is pushing to increase its popularity.
Yes, one of the things we are doing is to introduce Go in public schools, not only like elementary schools, but also middle schools or high schools and universities. In universities, some schools would open some elective classes to introduce this game. And then in elementary school, it's usually extracurriculum classes. And then students can come and then learn this game, and then they can also hang out with their friends using this game. So it's spreading among young people.
South Korea's Ha Jin Lee is the global ambassador at this year's Sport Accord World Mind Games. As well as playing the game professionally, Lee is also Secretary General of the World Go Federation. It was a move which raised eyebrows in some quarters.
When I was appointed as Secretary General, there were a lot of concerns, I'm aware, especially because of my age. I was a lot younger than my predecessor. But I believe the board of directors believe that some youth could bring new changes and new energy, and then maybe some passion for the new projects. So I believe that's what I was expected to do, and then I'm excited to do so.
The complex strategy sport, which dates back some 3,000 years, is played by some 40 million people worldwide. For it to be just as popular in 3,000 years' time, though, it needs to spread not just in terms of age, but also geographically.
Go is very well known and widely played in East Asia, but it's not as known in the West. And then we are trying our best to promote this game and raise the awareness of the game, but it's taking some time. We are not expecting to do it overnight. So we are doing it like slowly.
At the highest level, a Go game can go on for as long as 6 hours. It is this kind of complexity and unique nature that makes it so intoxicating, according to Ha Jin Lee.
Once you're into this game, it's very hard to get tired of it because of the depth and possible variations. It's just virtually unlimited. So I would say it can be very addictive as well.
And it is that addictive nature that Lee believes will be key to spreading the reach and popularity of the game, and which attracts premium brands like Rado to get involved. The game's popularity will not happen overnight, but events like the Sport Accord World Mind Games with its global exposure are vital parts of her and the Federation's vision.
My vision would be that Go would be the world mind sports, literally, so that people would be able to see this game, enjoy this game, and then access to the equipment wherever they are, and then whatever they are doing. I hope it will be more public and then friendly and available.
Meanwhile, on the Go tables on day one, Fan Hui, representing Europe, met China's Shi Yu in round one of the men's team event.
So, well, can you tell us about the first few moves?
The 5-3 point and the 5-4 point are relatively unusual moves. They work fairly well together when you're inviting your opponent into the corners to start a fight. And so basically that's what Black is doing here. Let's see, if White plays something in the lower left corner, we can assume Black is going to do something large scale, like for instance this.
Well, that's a very large scale.
Basically, yeah. I don't really know, but Black's idea is probably not to put moves in the corners, but to have something really big and control a lot of the board. Some players might play that move, again, another kukri. And Black's usually going to try to keep all his stones on the fourth line or higher, and control the center of the board.
And this is a really active plan here, which which White might want to avoid. But in order to avoid this kind of variation, White's going to have to approach the corner and then give Black the opportunity to start a fight.
Yes.
That's the idea, is it?
White usually does start an early attack the corner immediately. And naturally, now if Black is going to play something in the lower right, lower left, then now White's going to be taking the initiative in the fighting here.
Yeah.
And it's going to revert to a fairly normal opening, I suppose.
Okay.
Yeah. And so Black, again, plays an opening that's not really focusing on taking territory and just starting a fight here, which White has agreed to fight here. And we can see that White seems to have a lead in territory, but Black's going to be attacking. And so the question will be how skillfully White can settle his two weak groups, which are the group in the upper, on the upper side, and the group in the center here.
Okay.
And there is some Aji on the right side. There's a hole in White's position, for instance, this kind of thing. Now, for the time being, White's okay because he can play here. If Black plays this way, this is not going to be straightforward for Black. It's not going to be easy. Obviously, this is not good enough.
Yeah, yeah.
This would be a bit more complicated. It could be some kind of a call for it. Well, it could be a call.
But in any case, it's a tricky situation, and it will depend on exactly what's happening. And so White might have some center moves, for example. In
that's
that
not
going
to be a complete... Just let me do one more variation. Extending here is more likely to happen, although locally it doesn't work. Black's going to have all sorts of forcing moves in the center of the board.
Yeah.
And so Black's more likely to use those forcing moves to attack White in the center. And of course, the upper side again also is not very strong at this point.
Okay, so the plan is not to actually cut through directly, but just to use the weakness of the cut to gain some benefit on the outside for the fight.
Or when Black does cut, he's going to use it to make profit on the outside.
Okay, right.
There are some more variations, but I'll leave them for later.
Yeah.
There are some variations where Black does save those side stones.
Okay, well, it'll be interesting to see later in the game how, when this does happen, what actually occurs. Mm-hmm. Now, we just had Lee Hajin with us discussing this situation, and she was saying that she thought perhaps it was a bit difficult for White to consider this peep in the top right-hand corner followed by the cutting, because it's always going to be a difficult fight for White. Well, what do you think about that? Do you think it's a possible thing to try?
It's a bit dangerous for White. We can see here in this position, the game position here, White has two weak groups. Black has two groups that are not settled, but they're relatively strong. For instance, the right side group, by playing this the cut here that I was showing just now, can easily make two eyes.
Yes.
The upper side group has eye space also if Black wants to go. For instance, if...
therefore gives one victory to China.
Yes.
I mean, it was not terribly unexpected result, but nonetheless, the Chinese team will be pleased to have won their first game on their top board. And then I think tomorrow they're facing Korea,
yes.
Who's possibly
that's
the...
That's
a very important round, and possibly the two strongest teams that we have here. And so that will definitely be one to look out for.
Home victory there for China, and with that we wrap up the first day of this year's Sport Accord World Mind Games. See you tomorrow as day two kicks off, but for now it's goodbye.